Thanks for joining us tonight. At least 250 volunteers gathered in Eagan today to look for a young man missing since early Sunday morning. 23-year-old Bryce Borko was walking home alone after gathering with friends Saturday night. They lost contact with him at about 2 a.m.
Care 11's Lou Ragus spent the day in Eagan. He joins us now live with the latest on this investigation. Lou?
Police say they do not suspect foul play, but they're not sharing much of any information about what they think happened to Bryce. Now, a lot of people know Bryce and his family, so there's been a lot of support here all day long.
Okay, guys, let's head back this way.
Volunteers spending this unusually warm Halloween day combing through the woods and the valleys next to the Minnesota River in search of Bryce Borko, a 23-year-old last seen at 2 a.m. Sunday.
Our best guess is that we know he was in the area of Highway 13 and Yankee Doodle Road.
Eagan Police Chief Roger New says pings from Bryce's cell phone helped point investigators from that area down toward the Minnesota River. But Bryce's friends say his cell phone died Sunday before he could be found.
I mean, as you can tell, he's well-loved. He's got tons of people here with him and helping him try to get him home.
He's very caring, and he just cares really deeply about everybody.
Yeah. Probably the best person
he's very
I've
sweet.
Ever met.
After his friends and family put out that call on Sunday, 250 people showed up to help search on Monday for the young man who grew up in Rosemount. But Chief New says neither Bryce nor any further clues were found. The chief won't say exactly what police believe happened to Bryce, except that they have a bit of information they're keeping quiet out of respect for his family.
And I want to be respectful of that and walk them through some of the information that will come out in the near future. But, you know, needless to say, like I said, we don't suspect that there's any foul play at this time.
A lot of concerned people in Eagan hoping to at least bring peace to Bryce's family.
I just simply want to convey their thoughts and tokens of appreciation to the countless people that turned up and came out this morning to search.
Now, you can see behind me, there's still about 25 people here or so, and that's likely to be the last group to go out and search before it gets too dark. The authorities are taking them out very specifically in small groups because they're doing what's known as a grid search to make sure that they're hitting every specific area so it doesn't need to be searched a second time. Back to you.
All right, Lou, thank you.